Hello, my dear students. Look at this interesting puzzle that I've added to my collection. And as always, I've prepared some diagrams for you on our website. And today in the lesson, we will go over how to assemble this puzzle. It's called Yeet Ball. Let's get started.
Cubearea is where we start, solving puzzles with a master's art. From the first twist to the final move, watch as colors groove. Lessons clear, easy, no need to stress. We'll go step by step, no second guess.
Today we will not only assemble this ball, but we will also figure it out. What could possibly be common between these two intriguing and fascinating puzzles? We have many lessons. All puzzles relate to the 3x3 Rubik's Cube. All puzzles use 3x3 cube algorithms. This ball is no exception. Because all the puzzles we've previously covered on our channel are based on the algorithms we use for assembling the 3x3 Rubik's Cube. Well, let's dive into the details. Well, let's take a closer look. Each side of this puzzle consists of three parts. These two parts look like a triangle, and there's an element in the middle. I will call it the petal. I prefer to assemble the puzzle layer by layer. First, we will assemble this white, blue, red layer, and it more than the remaining. This is the top layer, and then we will assemble this upper part of the puzzle. Now let's scramble our puzzle and see how it can spin. This is how the rotation happens with this puzzle, in a step-by-step manner, and with careful consideration, so we can, in a way that effectively, turn the right side up, the left side up. Now, gently and carefully move the right side down, then the left side down, and finally the top layer to the right. In the first step, we will assemble the triangular elements of the white side, blue, and red. I'll start with the white one. Let's look for the second triangular part. Here it is for this side. Here it is. There are no special algorithms here. We just rotate the puzzle. The first connection of the white triangles. We have completed it. Now we will assemble the red side. Let's rotate this layer and find the second red piece from the red side. That's it. The combination. We have these two triangular red pieces ready. And the blue side remains. And it's already assembled. Basically, you'll have the same situation too. When you assemble two parts of two sides, the third one will be assembled automatically. That's it. The first stage is complete. Just like with the Rubik's Cube, in this puzzle we use the right hand and left hand algorithm. These are very simple algorithms that consist of four moves. And in most cases for this puzzle, we will mainly use the right hand algorithm. And only in one situation will we need to use the left hand algorithm. But let's go through everything step by step. If you've already watched some of our lessons, then you're already familiar with the right hand algorithm and the left hand algorithm. This means you won't have to learn anything new. You already know everything, and you'll just apply your knowledge when assembling this puzzle. To place this white petal in its spot on the white side, we hold the puzzle. So, if the petal is on the right, we apply the right-hand algorithm. That's it. The petal is in place. Now let's look at the situation where we need to use the left-hand algorithm. This white petal needs to be placed on the white side, but it's on the left. So we need to use the left-hand algorithm. The petal is in place. Let's figure out what happens to the puzzle when we apply the right-hand algorithm. And here's what happens. This petal takes this spot. This blue petal, it goes right here. And this yellow petal will take the place of the white one. That's the whole philosophy of this algorithm. The other elements of the puzzle do not change their position. The movement occurs only between these three petals. Step into the zone where puzzles come alive.
Cubearea.fun, teaching kids to thrive. Twist it, turn the Rubik till it's all aligned. Color spinning fast, gotta sharpen your mind.
In the second stage, we assemble the petals of the white side, the red side, and the blue side. Well, let's start with assembling the white petal. We take the puzzle in such a way that the white side is here. I'm lucky right now because the white petal is on the same layer. But since it's on the left, we already know that we can apply the left-hand algorithm, and this white petal will take its correct position. But since it's on the left, we already know that we can apply the left-hand algorithm. And this white petal will take its correct position. Let's apply the algorithm. The white petal is in place. Now let's move on to assembling the petal. On the red side, we need to find it on this layer. It's not there. So the needed red petal is somewhere here. Let's take the puzzle. So to have the red side at the bottom, we can apply the left-hand algorithm from this position. Since this is the top layer, we can easily rotate it or use the right-hand algorithm from this position to assemble this petal. It's up to you. I will apply the right-hand algorithm. The red petal is in place. Now let's assemble the petal on the blue side. The petal we need is on the top layer. Let's find it. Here it is. Hold the puzzle. So the blue side is at the bottom since the petal is on the right. Let's apply the right-hand algorithm and this petal will take its correct position. Let's apply the algorithm. Let's take a look at our first layer. And all three sides are fully assembled. And with that, the second stage is complete. You can find videos, lessons, and simple diagrams on our website, Cubearea.fun. Here is our first assembled layer. Now we just need to assemble the last top layer. Please take the puzzle. The white side is right here in front of you. Now we need to combine the lower parts of these sides by color with the petals. So this combination is ready, this combination is ready, and this combination is ready. After we've combined these parts by color, we need to perform the following actions. We can perform this manipulation once or twice, a maximum of two. Next, after combining these parts, we need to apply the right-hand algorithm. We apply the algorithm once. Next, we turn the top layer and place the white petal right here on the right. We apply the right-hand algorithm again. Once. Let's restore our combinations and take a look. Your puzzle might already be assembled, but I want to reiterate that this manipulation can be done once or, as in my case, twice. I'm applying this manipulation the second time. Let's check that we have a connection. Right here between these details, I'm applying the right-hand algorithm from the position where the white is located here. I'm applying the right-hand algorithm once. Next, I'm turning the top layer to the left. I'm placing the white petal right here on the right. I'm applying the right-hand algorithm once. I'm restoring our combination by color. And our puzzle is ready. Guys, while I was recording a tutorial for you, I received two more deliveries with new cubes. There's something really interesting there. If we have time, we'll make an unboxing video. So please don't forget to subscribe and leave comments. This is very, very important for the growth of our channel. We're doing our best for you. Please support us. See you in the next videos. Bye-bye. Cubearea fun, teaching kids to thrive. Twist it, turn the Rubik till it's all aligned. Color spinning fast, gotta sharpen your mind. Cubearea is where we start. Solving puzzles with the master's art. From the first twist to the final move, watch those colors grow. No need to stress. We'll go step by step, no second guess. Free for all the kids who wanna be the best. Rubik's secrets will divest. Cubearea.